Coming up next on the Met Report, hurry up and wait. That's what students had to do all over campus on their first day back.
And the central classroom gets a makeover. Plus,
I'm Walter Allen. A new year brings a new major to Metro State. Up next, I'll show you why we're the first to offer it.
I'm John Romero. Coming up, we'll take a look at which former Roadrunners ended up here in the NBA.
You're watching The Met Report with Elisa Vasquez, Eric Lufer, and Stephen Peisman on sports. The Met Report starts now.
After 9 years at Metro State, head basketball coach Mike Dunlap is no longer a Roadrunner. I'm Elisa Vasquez.
And I'm Eric Lufer. Dunlap accepted an assistant coaching position with another team. With more on the story is sports reporter John Romero.
You know, everybody's going to miss him, but at the same time, everybody's really happy for him, too.
He's earned it. I mean, he's been here for 9 years, gave it his all for all 9 years, and this is definitely an honor that he deserves.
After 9 years at the helm of the Metro State Roadrunners, Coach Mike Dunlap has resigned to join the Denver Nuggets of the NBA.
I've taken a huge risk by doing this, but with that risk comes a return that long-term will pay off.
This marks the first time since 1995 that an NCAA Division II coach has made the jump directly to the NBA, and it was no easy decision for Coach Dunlap.
The difficulty was that it was almost that I had to make the decision to do what I've done because I wanted to get better as a coach.
When he told me he was offered the job, I went back and forth for a week right along with him. Should he take it, not take it, because that's my job. I was trying to figure out what was best for him, and about 2 days before he took it, I said to him, Mike, I think you should take this.
There was never any question that Coach Mike Dunlap could get it done not only in the RMAC, but the NCAA. The question now is, how is he going to do in the big show?
He's one of the best basketball minds in the country, you know, and I think in Colorado, in this area and on this campus, everybody's seen that. And it's awesome that the Nuggets, you know, George Karl has been able to realize that.
I mean, it's George Karl's team, and Coach Dunlap understands that. So, I mean, he's an assistant coach again, and I think he'll adjust really well to that.
My strategy was to keep it simple, and I'm either in this gym working with players or I'm on the film machine. And so it's gone fast.
And no matter where he's at, Coach Dunlap will always be a Roadrunner at heart.
Absolutely. 9 best years of my career, if you look at everything that has happened, and that'll never change. I love the school, and it was a 9-year run that will be in the top 1 percentile, Division 1, 2, or 3, for all time.
I hope when Melo's messing up or some of those guys messing up that they get a rocket like we did.
John Romero, Met Report Sports.
Dunlap won 83% of his games as Metro's head coach. With over 20,000 students enrolling this semester, the first day of classes proved to be quite chaotic.
Classes are just packed. It's been pretty crazy. I just tried getting lunch and the line for Subway was ridiculous. And I was in the library earlier and there's madness everywhere.
Students would wait for more than an hour to get their new student IDs. The ID renewal line for non-freshmen was also backed up. At some points, over 100 students would be waiting in line. I didn't even want to go in there.
I lucked out. I went on my third day and there was like no line at all, so I don't know when I hit it.
I didn't even get my sticker yet, whatever that sticker is for your
I think that's important. ID. You're going to need that.
Well, alrighty. We'll do that eventually.
That's a good plan. Metro is the leading college in Colorado for renewable energy. Auraria campus has purchased 17 million kilowatt hours of renewable energy, which is enough to power 45% of our entire campus. The money came from the $1 clean energy fee students pay with their tuition.
A new stop has been constructed for all Metro-bound RTD buses. The new roundabout is located closer to the north classroom. The old stop near the Tivoli caused some safety issues in past years. Students would cut across the road in front of oncoming buses. The new stop doesn't have nearly as much pedestrian traffic.
Well, in addition to making the campus safer, Metro has also worked on making it more convenient. Over the summer, Metro remodeled the first floor of the central classroom. In addition to getting a brand new paint job, it's also home to several new offices, including student support services, new student orientation, and student academic success. For a full list of all the office moves that took place this summer, visit Metro Connect.
With Metro's increase in popularity, many classrooms are too small to accommodate the amount of students that are enrolled. Heather Burke takes a look at how serious this problem has become.
kind of sucks. You have to pay all this money, and then you come to class, and you have to, like, find somewhere to sit in a corner. Everybody's, like, staring at you.
Well, it's kind of nerve-wracking in the beginning when you're trying to set up class.
What's nerve-wracking for teachers and students are the overcrowded classes.
It feels like high school.
Now becoming an issue this semester.
I'm trying to do, like, a small group exercise, and the room is so small that I don't have enough room for the people to really stand up and move around freely like they should. They're like crawling over each other.
Students have their own ideas of what's causing the problem.
It seems kind of unfair when you're actually enrolled in the class and then you have to go to an overfilled classroom and then all the waitlist people are in there sitting in your seat.
But I registered late too, so I'm like one of the kids, it's making it crowded.
In fact, some of these smaller classrooms are becoming so overcrowded that many people are worried that it's soon going to become a fire hazard.
Particularly if something broke out in the room and then the students started running, they would run over each other.
I hope there's never a fire.
Heather Burke for the Met Report.
So, you know, after Heather's story, I went into the West Classroom. You know that little area between the Central and West classroom? The classes are dinky. I mean,
They're really small. We have issues all over the place with just having too many students and not enough space.
That's right. Couldn't get to the office in the first day of class. Can't get into class anymore. Ridiculous. We'll be right back. We'll take a break.
For just $15 per semester, students at Metro State can take advantage of all the different ways to stay in shape, stay alert, and feel good. Campus Recreation offers group classes, an open gym to practice your game, a brand new climbing wall, and a fully equipped weight room for experts and beginners. The gym is open Monday through Saturday. For hours and more information, visit Metro Connect.
Visit themetreport.com to find the latest news, sports, campus life, and this newscast all in streaming video whenever you want it. You can also find out about the people behind the scenes, our awards, and watch old stories all at themetreport.com.
Integrated therapy is a new degree offered by Metro State this year. Walter Allen shows us why it's making history.
This is the first four-year degree, bachelor's degree in integrative therapies in the United States.
The integrative therapy major brings together alternative therapies and what we call Western medicine.
That's the new thing, is to combine the best of both.
Traditionally, healthcare has just treated the sickness or ailment. Holistic medicine focuses on a lot more than that.
So you treat them not just as a physical body or as a disease, you treat their mind, their body, their spirit, their emotions.
Studies show holistic medicine, like using certain berries and oils, promotes health and helps fight disease.
The elderberry makes it so that it's hard for the virus, the flu virus, to attach to the human cell. And so if it can't attach to our cells, it can't replicate, it can't grow, and it can't make us sick.
One of the reasons Metro is the only college to offer this degree is because not only did we have people that wanted to teach, but students who wanted to learn.
The students kind of said, we want more, and then these people who were really qualified to teach, and that was their specialty, showed up, or I'd run into or meet them, and I have no qualms about saying, you want to teach? And they're fabulous.
Med schools all across the country are beginning to offer courses in integrated therapies, and Metro State doesn't mind leading the pack. Walter Allen for the Med Report.
Last week, professors and students from the Auraria campus held a discussion asking, does peace have a chance in the Middle East? Students were able to voice their thoughts and opinions of the ongoing violence. For more on the discussions and how Metro's Gay, Lesbian, Bisexual, Transgender Student Services plans to promote GLBT Awareness Month, pick up a copy of the Metropolitan all around campus.
Renovation of the Tivoli Student Union continues this year. On August 21st, the old boiler room became a studying area. The facility has two plasma TVs and is also wireless friendly. The boiler room used to be a bar and grill, but in 2003 it was shut down because the owners couldn't pay their lease. For 37 years, Colorado has proudly honored the tradition of German heritage by celebrating Oktoberfest. This is our news covering Denver. On September 8th, the fest returns to Larimer Square. The festival runs for 2 weekends. There will be live entertainment, children's activities, and plenty of food. For more information, visit info@oktoberfestdenver.com. And I've never been there.
I went last year. It is a lot of fun. We should take a camera and we should all go out there together, the Met Report.
Sounds good to me.
Well, we'll be right back with Stephen Peisman in sports.
Coming up in sports, all your teams are back in action. We're taking a look at this year's volleyball squad, plus the Pie Man's Bakery. We're cooking up some cheese.
You know, Romy, a lot of people ask me how you get so excited about a sports program that does not have a football team.
What do they know?
Met Report Sports, your number one source for highlights, interviews, and all things Metro Athletics.
Steve, the women's soccer team back on the field, a new season.
Yep, they're ready to go. We had, some disappointment at the end of the last season, but it's all looking good from now. After an undefeated season, a heartbreaking loss in a shootout in the NCAA tournament, losing many key seniors like Amy Licklider and Stephanie Prouty, the number 5 ranked women's soccer team is back and ready to start their campaign towards another championship. It all starts here against the number 6 ranked West Florida Argonauts. It took 6 games for an opponent to score on the Roadrunners last season. It took 3 minutes this season as Amanda Light floats it past Rachel Zollner. Amira Abel ties the game at 1, taking the long pass and deflecting it in. Now, this might just be the hardest goal freshman Becca Mays has ever worked for, as she takes it past the defense, gets almost knocked over not once, but twice before she finally slips it past goalie Courtney Jones. That would be all the cushion Metro needed as they take the win 2-1. On to the next game. It was a nice day for soccer, you know, if you like cold, rainy, windy days. Attention opponents, when Kylie Hanovan cuts to the middle of the field, start walking towards the center line to take the kickoff because the ball is going in the net. She had a hat trick in this one. Amira Abel stays hot, getting her second goal in as many games. Jamie Stevenson gets robbed by the post here, but Kira Sharp and her awesome neon green cleats kick it in for her first goal of the season. I mean, those things are just cool, right? It just continued from there as 8 different players scored a goal in an 11-1 domination. The women have picked up right where they left off, running their record to 4-0 with wins over St. Edward's and New Mexico Highlands. Kylie Hanovan was named the RMAC Offensive Player of the Week for the 8th time in her career, and freshman Jenna Oney has been named the RMAC Defensive Player of the Week for the first time. The women go on the road this weekend, facing Mesa State and Fort Lewis. On to the men, who were looking to start off their season off on the right foot against Midwestern State. Season underway. Midwestern State takes the 1-0 lead as Brandon Calvert shows his aerial skills to find the back of the twine. Calvert was all over the field as he robs Metro of their first goal of the game. The Roadrunners just couldn't get it going, finding themselves down by 2 going into the second half. With 37 seconds left, Kellen Johnson makes it a 1-goal game with Ohio. Sean Elbaum ties the game with 14 seconds remaining to send this one to overtime. All that dramatic comebacking for nothing, though, as Midwestern State takes the win in the 3rd minute of the extra session. The men have a 2-2 record on the season, going on to defeat Regis and West Florida and falling to number 1 ranked Fort Lewis. Next up for the men, on to the road to the School of Mines and back at Auraria to take on the Masters. Metro State volleyball is underway. Elisa Vasquez gives us a look at what we can expect from our Roadrunners this season.
That sound means only one thing. The Roadrunners are back on the volleyball court. The team spent the first 2 weekends of play fine-tuning their skills.
The first 2 weekends we wanted to win, but we also wanted to make sure that we were improving with each match. And so even in a couple of our losses, I think we saw some big gains.
The Roadrunners have 5 returning players, including senior Sheena Bohannon, Megan Wittenberg, and Stephanie Allison, who was just named the RMAC Player of the Week.
You know, Stephanie Allison's been a leader for us for quite some time, and you know, we expect her to lead.
The Roadrunners hold plenty of potential for the future with their new recruits for the 2006 season. Newcomer and junior Bree Osler has shown her stuff by coming up with 108 digs in the first 7 games alone. Freshman Amy Watanabe has already helped improve the runners' game with her powerhouse serving. A big change for the Roadrunners this season is the loss of RMAC Setter of the Year, Gabrielle Curtis, and the addition of freshman Stephanie Levi.
Steph's doing a great job. You know, she's a very physical kid, and she's still learning a lot about the game at this level, but she's learning quickly, and she's going to be a good one. She really is.
The question is, does this year's team have what it takes to make it trip lucky number 7 to the RMAC tournament?
I expect to win, actually. We have a really good team, and it's all starting to come together, and so I expect to do some pretty good things.
The women co-hosted the 11th annual Colorado Premier Challenge with Regis this weekend. Let's drop in on the Nest for highlights of their game against number 7 ranked Washburn. Metro came out of the gates looking a bit rusty, and you can't make mistakes against a nationally ranked opponent, but it is early in the season. Tessa Jones led Washburn with 13 kills, Julie Green led Metro with 12 kills, and we can't forget about the player of the week, Stephanie Allison, throwing down 11 of her own. In volleyball, nothing seems to make me happier than a hit to the face, and oh, here's one now. Nice. Metro falls to Washburn 3-1. Metro closed out the Premier Challenge with 2 wins against Mesa State and Augustana. They now hold a 3-4 record on the season going into conference play this weekend at the Nest. Now, I know you've been craving it all summer, so let's reopen the bakery for business. Our first special of the semester is cheese. That's right, cheese. So what best describes the next clip? A, Gouda, that had to hurt. B, she moderate jacked that one. Or C, she really put some cheddar on that kick.
I'm not sure if I want to do this game this year.
I am so excited to play. I hope I can beat you as good as Amora did.
I'm going to be on my A game this time. I'm going to go with Monterey jacked it.
Monterey jacked it.
Let's take cheddar.
Cheddar. Monterey Jack, cheddar. Well, Eric, you start off on the right foot. The answer is B. She Monterey jacked that one right into Elisa Wolfer's face. Elisa was a little confused afterwards, but got right back into the play like a true athlete.
I've been studying up.
I can't believe I lost to you. I didn't do Amora proud.
That's very disappointing.
I'll have to work on it. All right, well, before we go, we would just like to take a moment to let you know that our own Met Report was nominated for 2 Collegiate Broadcasters Incorporated Awards.
Yes, we were. One for Best Newscast and Best Sportscast, which... Congratulations, Steve, for that great honor. Good job, buddy.
Great job.
Thank you. It just shows what a great staff we have at the Met Report that we keep getting nominated for all these awards.
That's right. Well, thank you, Steve. That's going to do it for this edition of the Met Report. For Stephen Peisman and Elisa Vasquez, I'm Eric Lufer. We'll see you on campus.